All right, he's a multi-Grammy award-winning hip-hop artist and an author on the New York Times bestsellers list. And now, Christian rapper and singer Lecrae is gearing up for his latest project. Take a listen. It's a six-part financial education web series called Protect the Bag. Lecrae's teaming up with leading information services company Experian to produce a series which combines scripted sketches and guest interviews. Take a look.
Now, of course, we can't talk about protecting the bag if you don't know what the bag is. And no, I'm not talking about a Gucci or a Louis or a Chanel or a Birkin bag. See, the bag I'm talking about is literally like a bag of money. It's safety, it's financial security. It's knowing what is and isn't legacy. Let's just call the bag financial health.
All right, we need all the advice we can get. Lecrae is with us today. Lecrae, thank you so much for joining us here on the Midday Jolt.
Absolutely, honored to be here. Thank you for having
me. All right, so you're tackling financial health with your web series, Protect the Bag, like we just saw. What can people expect watching this?
You know, what they can expect is a variety show that encourages and enables people to understand how to deal with their finances. We want people to be, you know, informed and create generational wealth for their families, but at the same time, do it in a way that's also entertaining. And so we just changed the format on what on how financial health and financial literacy is being taught.
Now, Lecrae, along with your music and rap blazing through those Billboard charts, I understand that you do a lot of help to, you know, work to help out the community, such as bringing masks to inmates out in Georgia. What made you want to help people get their finances in order? I know we all struggle with that, just kind of prioritizing that throughout the day.
Yeah, well, what I've seen is in my own life, I didn't have a lot of help in a lot of particular areas, and finances was one of them. So it was something that I had to learn on the fly. And I wanted to make sure that I'm helping out communities, especially marginalized communities, understand, you know, how to become the best version of themselves. And oftentimes people are forgotten about in different aspects of society. And so I wanted to contribute. That's just something that's always been a part of my MO is how can I bring a sense of peace and clarity to folks who need it? And if I have it, I want to make sure they have access to it.
I love that. So, of course, you're a best-selling author, an artist, and so much more. Is there a situation or a challenge that you faced along the way that made you rethink how you take a look at your finances?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, being an artist and you know, coming across, you know, a different type of finance that I would not have experienced as a kid, there was no preparation for me. You know, my mother didn't know what to do. So I had to learn a lot on the fly. I didn't know about investing. I didn't know about savings. I didn't know about credit. I didn't know about debt. And so more things I had to learn on the fly. I remember just seeing so many celebrities getting caught up with an IRS or going to prison. I wanted to not fall into that category. So I started learning. And the more I learned, I said, man, other people need to know this. And I started teaching some of the artists on my label. And then that turned into me wanting to teach more and more people, and then this series was birthed.
I love that. Now, give us that advice, especially to people of color when it comes to maintaining their financial health or just even getting started. Like you mentioned, it took you a while to get started and actually know what you need to do to protect your finances.
Yeah, well, you know, being a part of the Black community, we have $1.4 billion of spending power. And yet, you know, our money leaves our community within 6 hours. People of color, you know, represent 20 to 25% of, you know, the purchasing of things like perfume or luxuries. But at the same time, we represent 1% of the stock market. And so if we're going to see our financial futures change, we have to be educated. We have to become aware. And so we're just giving some basic tips in an entertaining way, and then allowing people to dig deeper and providing resources for them to really grow their finances and to really change the narrative of people of color in this country.
I love that. All good advice that we can definitely all use. Lecrae, thank you so much for being here on the Midday Jolt. We really appreciate all your words of wisdom, for sure.